This was the Tiger Challenge as the 1995 baseball season dawned. Clemson's 40-year-old head coach, Jack Leggett, took Clemson to the number one ranking in the nation for the first time ever in 1994, his rookie season. He added an ACC regular season championship, an ACC tournament championship, and a trip to the NCAA tournament. Now, as a second-year head coach, he would be leading the hunted instead of being the young upstart. Additionally, the Tigers' resume of goals had one item that was not achieved in 1994, a trip to the College World Series.
Win! 1, 2, 3! Win! Come on!
This could be dangerous.
Clemson began the season ranked in the top 10 of every preseason poll, and the Tigers lived up to the advanced billing, winning 25 of their first 26 contests. A 25-game winning streak included two wins over an eighth-ranked and future College World Series opponent from Tennessee. Those victories featured a classic confrontation between All-Americans Shane Monahan and Todd Helton. Seven more wins in the second longest winning streak in ACC history took place against Old Dominion and James Madison, who were ranked in the top 25 at the time. During the streak, Clemson opened its ACC schedule with 9 consecutive wins. Other highlights of the streak included a triple play turned by the Clemson defense against George Mason and Gary Burnham's hitting for the cycle against UT Arlington. Clemson entered the first weekend of April ranked number one in the nation in all three polls. Interest in Tiger baseball was at an all-time high. Record crowds turned out for a 3-game series with North Carolina. The series opened with a superb performance by Billy Koch, who carried a no-hitter to the eighth inning of Clemson's 3-2 victory. On Saturday, Clemson posted a 20-1 victory over the Tar Heels, Clemson's largest margin of victory in an ACC game in 9 years. The rout took place in front of a satisfied crowd of 6,223, the largest crowd in Clemson history. The Tigers went on another winning streak, this time a 10-gamer between April 7th and April 19th. The highlight of the streak took place in Raleigh, April 14th. On this night, the Tigers pulled off the impossible, making up an 11-run deficit in the top of the ninth before pulling out a 17-15 victory in 10 innings. It was the greatest comeback in Clemson baseball history. Tigers sent 16 batters to the plate to erase a 15-4 Wolfpack lead. Shane Monahan's 3-run homer a key blow, but Rusty Rhodes' 2-run single sent the game into extra frames. Matthew LaCroix's double won it in the 10th. Clemson ended the month of April like it had begun, winning an ACC series over a longtime rival. The Tigers swept 3 games from Georgia Tech. The final game of the series, the first game ever televised from Tiger Field. Shane Monahan, a first-team All-American in 1994, showcased his talent that night at the plate and in the field.
Monahan coming over. He will make the catch. Tagging at third is Thomas. Here comes the throw. The tag. They got it. Double play. What a move by Jack Leggett.
Monahan was 4 for 4 with 2 doubles and 2 RBIs. He also threw a potential game-tying runner out at the plate and made a diving catch to preserve a 6-5 Tiger win. With a record of 46-10, the Tigers headed into the ACC tournament as the regular season champions and top seed in the tournament. Clemson opened up with a win over Maryland 10-0 behind a one-hitter pitched by Jason Dawson. This was the first one-hit shutout in ACC tournament history. The team defeated North Carolina 6-4. Then picked up a big win over Florida State 11-0, the Seminoles' largest margin of defeat in 197 games. The Tigers faced NC State, and for the fourth time this season and fifth straight over two seasons, Clemson recorded double-figure runs with a 16-7 victory. Later the same day, Florida State got revenge on Clemson. The Seminoles defeated the Tigers 12-2 to force a final game on Sunday. Florida State won that game also 8-2 to claim its first ACC tournament title. During the tournament, it was announced that Clemson had swept all three of the ACC awards, a first in ACC history. Coach Jack Leggett was named ACC Coach of the Year for a second consecutive season. Leggett became just the third coach in ACC history, regardless of sport, to win ACC Coach of the Year in his first 2 years at an ACC school. Freshman Matthew LaCroix picked up Rookie of the Year honors with his .346 average, Clemson freshman record of 15 home runs in a season. Shane Monahan was selected as Player of the Year with his .385 average. Jason Dossie and Scott Winchester were named first-team All-ACC pitchers. David Miller was the first-team All-ACC first baseman. Paul Galloway was named second-team All-ACC, but became Clemson's first-team academic All-American in history. Clemson was chosen to host the NCAA East Regional for a second consecutive year. Tigers were the favorites to reach a goal that had eluded them since 1991, a trip to Omaha.
Bucket!
The Tigers opened with a win over six-seeded Navy 8-4. Galloway showed he is equally successful on the field as in the classroom, as the junior with six consecutive four-point semesters blasted two home runs. Clemson then defeated Jacksonville 11-5 in the second round, thanks to a 16-hit attack, including a home run by Seth Reisig and three hits by Shane Monahan and Matthew LaCroix. Against Winthrop in round three, second baseman Doug Livingston provided the power with a home run in a key five-run eighth inning. On Sunday night, Clemson met Alabama for the championship. In the eighth, the Tigers blew open a 4-4 tie behind the hitting of Will Duffy. Duffy had a triple down the right field line to score two runs. He scored on a suicide squeeze play to make it the final 7-4. Save grabbed the win in his final game at Tiger Field, while Scott Winchester recorded the save and was the center of the celebration. While Clemson was unsuccessful in its two games in Omaha, the 1995 season was certainly a landmark year in Clemson baseball history. A record five Tigers were named to at least one All-America team. The list included Shane Monahan, the only player in ACC history to be named Conference MVP, Conference Tournament MVP, and NCAA Regional MVP over a career. Gary Burnham was a third-team All-American thanks to his .340 average, ACC best 27 doubles. David Miller made many All-American teams and was a first-round draft pick of the Cleveland Indians. Jason Dossie led the staff in wins with 11 and was a second-team All-American, while Scott Winchester was one of the top relief pitchers in the nation with an ACC best 14 saves. Shortstop Seth Reisig also received All-ACC and All-NCAA tournament honors, and Matthew LaCroix was chosen as a first-team freshman All-American. It was truly a special year in Tiger baseball as this program continues to establish itself among the best in the nation. Clemson's top 10 final ranking for a second straight year gives the Tigers a strong foundation as it celebrates its 100th year.
thrill. This is the greatest escape ball of mine. I let it love. It drives me crazy. It's just great balls of fire.